Greetings, greetings, everyone. The Whitney in just a minute just posting a link around for the stream. That's it for the posting. Let me fire up ZBrush here. Is my mic on? Yeah, my mic's on. Let me tone down the music. Like we got a new version of ZBrush coming out. Maybe we'll see some updates to the dynamics. Would be cool. Or whatever they do will be cool. It's a point release, so there'll be something significant, and more than likely it would seem like it would be to the dynamics. Anyway, let me get that out of the way. So yeah, again, I am working on this cyberpunk engineer, this anime-styled cyberpunk engineer. A long ways to go yet. Today I kind of want to start to take a look at some of this hardware on the character. You can see she has some type of leg. Let me get EpiPen out. There you are. So we can see we got some, and I'm guessing it really does look like some type of leg brace, some kind of leg support system. It's not a prosthetic leg, but it comes through here. Kind of got this going on. So I'm sure it kind of encompasses the leg a little bit, but I'm going to try to find some reference for something like that, because I have seen stuff like this before. I have seen them before. And so it connects to these leg straps. It looks like that's the reason for these leg straps. And we got little tools and stuff in here, but mainly the hardware. And this, I guess, is a welder, some type of welding device, maybe. Or just a piston, I'm not sure. But yeah. This kind of runs along these straps on the leg here. And I'll probably take a look at the coat a little bit as well. You know, take a look at the coat. So that's that. These knee pads in here, I'm not sure if they're finished or not, so I may go back to them. Kind of not crazy about the shape of them. I mean, they just need a little work. Alright, but they're in place for now. I'll throw the color on. And I did a little bit of work on the coat offline. A little bit of sculpting, a little bit of dynamics. There's quite a bit to go yet. And I might change it yet. I might change some things on it. To have more of like a choker piece that connects it to the neck instead of the hood. Because the hood, kind of like when the hood's on, I don't know. It's cool and all, but maybe if it was closer in. But I think it kind of interferes with the silhouette a little bit, you know. Kind of like the cleanness of the silhouette. You know, whereas if she had a little choker, if it was more of like a collar around the neck, that looks like it would kind of fasten onto the choker around her neck. Just kind of opens up the silhouette around the head a little better. So I might do that. Then again, it's only on her waist, but I did want to do a version with the thing up, so it kind of, you know, because it kind of will explain like what it is, what it actually is. Anyway, I'm gonna move into looking up some reference for this. You know, I'm just gonna kind of do random searches here. Also been entertaining the idea of doing another illustrative piece, like maybe this. I really like this, like kind of from start to finish, you know, blocking out the base mesh and everything. It's fairly simple, but I, for some reason, I just would like to see, you know, do this water and stuff in real time and everything, and the reflections, and just do a really cool render. But that's something else. Anyway, let's see. How can I find this? Engineer leg supports. Let's see. Mechanical engineer leg system. Let's see if that turns up anything. It kind of does. It kind of turns up this. I guess it's a kind of exoskeleton. But this is seems like, here we go, right there. And see, that's more engine embrace, so, but at least it's something. I don't think hers is quite that, you know. I'm not sure. It could be. I don't really see like an engine mechanism in it. I do see some wires though that kind of go around to the back side, so maybe it is actually something like that. It's really hard to tell, but you know, that's an area where you can kind of be So here's more stuff. Yeah, we got lots of stuff here, so. I'm surprised that turned up anything out that search, but. Design and control of hybrid actuation lower limb exoskeleton. So, yeah. Dude, this one's actually pretty cool. Yeah, this kind of seems more along like what it is on the character here. So let's grab that. Oops. Let's grab this. Wait, where did it go? Where did it go? This is cool around the backside. I don't know, maybe I'll do something like that and put this on and build that thing on her back. Would actually be pretty cool. Because it's more along the lines of what she has, or is looking more along the lines of what she has. But yeah, we're turning up some cool stuff here. I do want to try to find the one I had though. So yeah, just because you have a concept, you know, I mean, doesn't mean you won't need reference for something, you know, especially when you don't know what the hell it is. You just take a best guess, you know. Where was that other one I really liked? I just had it and it disappeared on me. Getting lost. Images are tiny. Images are tiny. Here's the one I had. Come on. Stop it. Stop it. Chill out. It's my cat. She wants to act up because I'm doing something. Oh yeah, there it is. There it is. Okay, let me grab it. This. But yeah, for the jacket, I think I'm gonna move something to like a collar like that instead of the hood. And I was explaining that a little earlier. Kind of touched on that a little earlier. Let's see what else can we grab. Suex Phoenix Exoskeleton is the lightweight and affordable. Okay. Now there we got another deal. Thank you. something. Image is kind of tiny, teeny weeny. See, this is actually pretty cool too. This one over here, kind of like some of the shapes in that. Kind of got, you know, since you can't really see it well, I kind of got some liberty on there. Some liberty with it on there, liberty on. Is that all right? Oh geez, that's a tiny ass image. Oh wow. I do like this spinal column thing, and I do like this kind of, yeah, because she's got some wires going behind, so it's definitely, you know, got something like this going on. So, yeah. Let's see, let me grab one more thing. And then I gotta run out for a second to use the bathroom. Let's see, I think I've got enough stuff here to work with. Don't want to get too much reference. Just want to pick out a few key things and then kind of roll from there. Get some primitives blocked out. Oh yeah, this one is the one I wanted. I kind of like that whole backpack, but she's not that. That's more like combat stuff. It's more like combat, but I do kind of like some of these shapes through here. That would actually be pretty cool. Oh, there it is again. That's pretty cool. That's really cool. Maybe I'll model that. That would be fun. I'm gonna dive into some. Let me save some of these. Do 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 do. Do. But I need this. Tiny, tiny images. Well, maybe they're not that tiny, and just because some of this other stuff is so blown up. And I want to grab this one. And I think we're good. We're good for the time being. Well, this is pretty cool. But that's another character. I don't need that right now. Let me get out of Pinterest before I get lost. I'm already getting a little lost here. Don't really need those. Just gonna clean up some stuff I don't really need anymore. I don't really need that. Still kind of need that because part of her back showing. Oh shoot! Did not want to delete that. It's kind of like some back reference. I don't really need that. I still need that. So I think we got everything here. Yeah, I think I'm good. The ref is a rinse. Alright, I'm gonna take a little dip out for a second. I will be back shortly. Oops, let me turn. Step over now.
building. So let me, that off. Let me turn, let's get this coat out of the way for now. So I guess I'll start with some primitive shapes. Piston shape. Alright, I'm kind of liking this. So, kind of use, get a cylinder in here around the knee. That's kind of like an anchor point. I also have some turn local symmetry on. Because when you have local symmetry on, when you're working on, I don't always keep it on because you can throw off your whole model, like on the world axis. But like, if you're trying to like, with it off, you're gonna get, well, not for this piece so much, like when you scale and stuff, you're gonna get like weird stuff, like it's gonna try to scale it to the center of the world, whereas if it's on local, it, you know, when you go to scale and stuff, it'll be in the center of the object. So just a little note there. Oops. I do have some, I don't know, is this thing weird? This thing looks like it's warped. I do not want a warped cylinder here. And I'm going to go ahead and split that off. And I think I'll get... I want to go with more like square shapes. Thank you. this little light, so I'm thinking that that spinal column, like I might do this spinal column thing like this. That would actually be pretty cool. I actually like that. So, so let me go ahead and I guess I'll start with squares. I'll use squares for now, boxes, and just kind of boxes. See, one of these is like a there's a way to set it so like the image is transparent. I mean, so the canvas is transparent. I've seen people do it, but cylindrical piece up here, and I'm actually looking at this blue one. This blue one over here. That seems pretty close to what she might have, because you can see the little wire. Something and another going to the back side here. So yeah, well, parts of this, not that I'm not, I don't think I'm gonna do like the shin pieces, but anyway. also get her arms out of the way. Oh wait, I don't have polygroups on this? I did not realize that. I must have accidentally did something to them. It's okay, I can go ahead and create more. Not on the hands though, I don't want them on the hands. I want to keep my fingers while I grouped. So this actually has this piece coming out here. And for stuff like this, I like to use the gizmo extrude. I like to use extrude with the gizmo instead of the Z modeler one, because I can actually manipulate the shape a little better. So I can like scale. I can do that kind of scaling and just kind of move it around a little easier. So we got that piece happening like that. Edge loop through here, because it actually, it's always, you know, nice to get the surface changes into things. So yeah, that'll work. Oh no, it's not exactly what I want. Go ahead and add another edge loop. And you know what? Let me grab a few more polygons here. Let me grab these two as well. And maybe this one. Two extrudes. And that way we get that. You can actually, you know what? Let me clear this out, I can actually go ahead and extrude this once first. Extrude all. So we can actually get this shape in here. And let me come around to the top of this. Maybe right about here. Let me actually hide this. Numbers. There we go, I think we're good with that. Touch. Go ahead and scale this. Scale edge loop complete. Scale that out a little bit. Give it a poly group. Go to additive. this one. And then reapply it. Right. And then we got this piece right here, kind of. Slopes off, so you can just go ahead and polygroup this whole thing. Oops. Go ahead and mask that. And move it out. So it's actually something like this. It's actually probably a lot thin. Well, let's see here. Yeah, that is fairly thin. So let me grab the top of it. This number, and I can go ahead and extrude that to here. And it actually is round at the top. I'm gonna have to do these, I'm gonna have to break these off. Separately from the cylinder pieces. Let me make sure. Go ahead and mirror weld this stuff, make sure it's all good. Faces on this. That's fine. Go ahead. Bevel that. And give this. Oops. We don't want to do that. Shift extrude that up to give it to get that round top. And we can go ahead and bevel these again, and let's just pull it down to right about here. And there, we got that whole thing happening. looks like we got. Go ahead and poly draw this. This. Edge loops complete, slide this probably to about here, and then we got this other piece. It kind of comes out. Let me slide this up a little bit. So it comes out a step. One step and then a second step. It's actually got like three steps. So we got this step. Actually could have it kind of wrap the leg a little bit. Like such. Alright, that's fine. Select them and whatnot. And this whole piece can be extruded. Kind of don't like the way. You know what? I can just go ahead and grab this backside and extrude once. Front. gizmo extrude. Because that actually kind of rounds off. And yeah, I still like it. This gizmo extrude has been in ZBrush for a long time. And it's still one of my favorite ways to kind of bevel and extrude. And we just need to bring this one out a little. Without grabbing the other one. break. Use the bathroom real quick.
Thank you.
Alright, I am back. Back in the building. Back to work here. On the spine one, I like the shape. This right here. The way this comes off. Oops. Yeah, I like the way this kind of, you got this step scenario through here, so I'm trying to roll with that. Straighten that out. And I can go ahead and space. So dial these in a bit. There. Yeah, so just figuring this out. This piece can actually turn a little bit up. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do a little bridge here. Gizmo extrude on this. Oops, let's go to the local cemetery. Delete that. Delete hidden, and let me bridge this up with two holes, and let's do arcs. Oops. Ah. things happening towards the spine here. Put our jacket on. Yeah, the jacket's definitely gonna have to be adjusted. Go ahead and get my move dynamics. Cloth move, it's called cloth move. Just kind of match this up here. I don't know what it's gonna do at default. Okay, it's working pretty good. Collision volume and just see what happens. We just want gravity on. Just let it hang a little. Nope, I don't want that. Definitely don't want anything happening up there. Plate on there. You can just tuck that back in. Oops. Right here, but that's all right. It's only the final jacket anyway. It's definitely gonna need some work. I mean, I'm kind of redoing the collar and stuff, so. Hi, Pool Mop 1. Welcome to the stream. You meant high. Did you mean high? Hey man, how you doing? Yeah, I'm doing good. I'm doing good. Just working on my character here. Hey, what's going on, Victor? Just working on the it looks like she has a exosuit. That's what this exterior part is. Image search and came up with and found these, so they're like an actual thing, these exosuits. So I've been working, just blocking out the exosuit for her. And it looks like it's running along her legs here. Thanks. Thank you. Make this its own part so I can lower the poly count on the back belt here, because that goes on, that tucks on the inside of that. I really don't want so many polys on this part, because I'm actually gonna block some stuff up with it. Just trying to like give it some kind of shape as a mechanism. And it's just way easier to work with if it's not so many polys. Okay, now what are you doing there? Whoa. Oh, you know what? That's because I need to break it off first. Duh. You working on anything tonight, Victor, or you just... Shift extrude, same on the, yeah, I think go ahead and put that in there, on the top as well, keep this shape going. Hey, render me gone. How are you? Welcome to the chat. Keep it like that for now. wrong cube. I want the quad cube. So yeah, I'm basically... Yeah, yes, I'm creating an exoskeleton for this character. You can see it looks like she has one on the side of her legs here, and I actually just looked up like leg support systems, and I got all this reference for these exo suits. So I'm kind of loosely basing it off this one right here. I want to make this spinal column, and you can see she has like she's got the little LED light on her neck, so I figured that could, you know, it could work, and I can have the spinal thing. And so so I'm looking at this blue one, just kind of picking off different areas. I like this one, but this seems more like combat. But I do kind of like this one. That one's actually really cool. So yeah, just kind of mashing it out here, see what happens. So I'm getting ready to build up this spinal area right through here. So Oops. Oops. And get a center edge loop in here. I guess this can actually be a little flatter. More like this. These polys to bring it, extrude with poly group all, kind of bring those around the neck there. Actually gonna go ahead and flatten this, and then I can draw this around the neck. Oops. Can use the extrude move with snap to surface on, and just go ahead and wait a minute. What is going on there? There we go. Oops. No, I don't want to do that. Why are you doing that? Thanks, man. Thanks, render me gone. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah, I kind of work a lot slower on the stream. Kind of meandering with stuff. I need to block out this little spinal piece here. I think I'll just kind of extract it from Let's see what I can do. I'll do it. Control extrude. Kind of work with this. Turn off this jacket here. I do gotta take a, I gotta take a restroom break real quick. I will be back in just a few. Thanks a lot for hanging out, man.
Thank you.
back. Freshen up a little. That message. That's cool. Yeah, to freshen up a little, man. I actually made a spinal column for another character that was actually pretty cool, that would work really well for this. I don't know if I should dig it up. Dig it up and use it. See what I can make here. Where are some of you guys at, located? Dialing in from? Because usually this time of night, I usually get people, from overseas. Vancouver, Canada, so you're pretty much the same time zone, just about. Wait, let me make sure I know what I'm talking about. Vancouver. So that's on the west coast of Canada. Thank you. No, I'm not doing arms on it. It's just the legs. I mean, at least I didn't plan on it. Oops. Blade armor. Yeah, blade armature would be cool. But she's more like an engineer. So she just like fixes stuff. So
So I don't know. I don't know. We'll see. I'll see how it goes. It looks like for her arm, she just has like the little jacket like this. Something like on this character. Or like this.
Kind of like that for the top there. For now, and just oops. Oops. Maxed out mean you ran out of like RAM or something? Did it blow up on you? Was that in ZBrush? Marvelous designer, that computer, that uses a lot of CPU power. Yeah, I've got a an i9, and when I got it, it improved things quite a bit in Marvelous, but it's still like, if I really try to push it, you know, it. Marvelous will really, really bring things down to a crawl. A lot of applications really, really aren't multi-threaded that well. Like, I think ZBrush is about the only application that's multi-threaded in the capacity that it is. Oh, nice. Yeah, that's some really great clothes work.
Yeah, you did a great job on them clothes.
Yeah, that's looking good. This is Dylan McIsaac. Dylan McIsaac work. He's in the chat as Render Me Gone. It's his work right there. Some really nice stuff on the clothes. And the base mesh is nice too.
Yeah, I'm hoping, okay. Those animations that you did the animation in Maya, or are they running in a Marvelous Designer? Yeah, that'll definitely push your system to the limits. Yeah, Maya, as long as it's been around, man, you'd think everything in Maya would just be multi-threaded. But I guess I think some things are multi-threaded in Maya, but I think, like, for them to really do it, they would basically have to, like, rewrite the program or something. I even know, like, you know, like I said, I'm on an i9, and even like the retopology tools in Maya with the using quad draw and a constrained mesh and everything, and it comes to a crawl. Like after using it for like 30 minutes, it'll just start bogging down big time. That on the top, that's about it. I don't know if this is gonna work as a I should just stick to the one that's in the reference. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, there's just so much stuff. There's so much stuff in it. That's really where ZBrush was kind of forward thinking, and they're pixelogic, and they're like multi-threaded it, you know? Dig around in my IMM brush to see if I can get a cool shape for the spinal column. See if I can find something. Cool, like a bunch of base shapes, and I can't find that brush. I don't know if I accidentally removed it, because I recently had to clear out a bunch of brushes, but I use that one a lot, so I wouldn't think I would remove it. Oh no! I didn't know. I didn't even know they had an update for Topo Gun. Yeah, I used to use it all the time. That used to be my my go-to app for retopology and baking. I used to use it for baking too. And then Marmoset 3 came out, and I moved my baking over to there, and then more recently I've been using with the edge extrude move, just adding that one little simple feature in ZBrush. Now I retop in ZBrush. It's like it goes pretty quick, so I just kind of slowly moved away from Topo Gun. Yeah, I might have to check it out. They didn't do an update for like, geez, it was like seven. I think the last update they did was like in 2013 or something. So did they do anything with the baking as well? Is it like an overall improvement? And do they got any like auto retop functionality? I can't find that brush.
I cannot find it. I give up. There was a lot of cool stuff. A lot of cool shapes. Concept, but the reference I'm looking at. Yeah, I'm gonna definitely check it out. Yeah, and I used Topo Gun for quite a long time. I'll do like the same thing, just work with the front faces here. That way I can much oops. Yeah, they just kind of gave up for a long time. Jeez, I don't want to do that. No, I haven't. Yeah, I haven't heard anything. They just that they were, you know, they were had to leave Topo Gun, and you know, I would imagine maybe some kind of financial troubles, something along those lines. I see. That little piece. Can't have that. Thank you. Oops, no, we don't want that piece. Thank you. something like that. Then I'll probably have some
I think I've seen that. I think I've seen that tool. I think I know what you're talking about. It like preps it for Substance Painter. Yeah, I'll definitely check it out again. Cause I think I remember seeing it, and I can't remember if I ever downloaded it or what.
Switch it up. We switch up the morph target. So something like that. I need to get some wires in here. Oh, I know what I was gonna do. Yeah, because they actually.
I think it's, I'm not sure. I think it's more for probably a Neuralink situation. You know, it could be support for the legs. It could very well be that. But I would imagine it's like a whole system, you know, like you know, that can be expanded. That can be expanded on. It's how I'm kind of thinking about it. There we go, that could kind of work.
insert tubes. Let's see if we got that. They were in here for like ever. Insert cylinder. Is that insert tubes? Insert tubies. Tubes. Do that afterwards. Just gotta get some things going, but that's gonna be it for me. I am about to shut it down. Thanks to anyone that stopped by, check out the stream. Oh yeah, well yeah, I'm still playing. I'm gonna play around with it. Yeah. Yeah, I think it should be about like that, but then I want it to read pretty well and have some, you know, some broad edges being that it's stylized and everything. Should be a little smaller than that. Gotta figure that out.
Yeah, I'm gonna play with that too, like have it taper, because this is what I was, this was the vertebrae I was referencing, you know, so we'll see. I kind of want to get I see that's like fabric straps. That links, but yeah, this was basically what I was looking at. But yeah, I'm gonna try different things, like get it maybe off camera, try a few things. But yeah, I think that's it for me for tonight. I'm gonna head on out. Again, thanks for stopping by, people. And I hope you come back and check me out when I go live. I'll probably go live for a little bit tomorrow. All right, y'all. Good night or good morning, whatever it is for you. Peace.